University singers, that was wonderful. Could you all please help me thank them one more time by another round? These students perform under the direction of Dr. Karsten Longhurst, the Director of Choral Studies and Instructor of Music. The University singers will continue to share their gift of song with us later in this evening. Alumni, family, students, and friends. My name is Sherry Ward. I'm the Vice President and Nursing Representative on the Alumni Board. I would like to welcome you to the Spring Alumni Reunion 2024. If you haven't been back to campus in a while, we trust that you have discovered that our Northwestern looks great. Wouldn't you agree? At this time, I would like to welcome to the podium our President of Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Dr. Bo Hannaford.
Thank you, Sherry. It's a great day to be a Ranger. I want to thank you for being here, especially with dodging weather possibly on your way. We appreciate that. I want to first thank the Northwestern Foundation, Skeeter John and his staff. Let's give them a round of applause for setting up this wonderful evening. If you allow me just a few moments, I have a few special introductions. And the first is a pretty important one to me. I'd like to introduce my lovely wife, First Lady at Northwestern, Tara Hannaford. This next guest, I'm very impressed that she's here because I know she has crisscrossed the state this week because I've been in several meetings with her. But we're very fortunate to have our chair of the Russo Board, Regent Jane McDermott, and her husband Max with us tonight. And then finally, would you please help me welcome back a friend and a mentor, the 19th president of Northwestern Oklahoma State University, Dr. Janet Cunningham. Tonight is the night we celebrate our outstanding graduates, the distinguished classes, our outstanding seniors, and really, when you look at it, it's our community. To our outstanding graduates, I want to say congratulations, and I look forward to each and every one of your speeches tonight. To our outstanding seniors, we're proud of you. We expect great things from each and every one of you, and we know you're going to do great things in the future. And to our distinguished classes that came back, thank you again. You're always welcome back here at Northwestern. We're here tonight because each and every one of us love Northwestern, or possibly you love somebody that's going to be honored here tonight. Or simply, you value the impact that Northwestern has had on countless lives. The impact continues to be felt as we make great strides in our academic programs and our facilities. This year alone, we brought back our visual arts major and started strong with 18 majors in the program. We continue to move closer and closer to offering our MBA program that will include an option in healthcare management. We now offer 10 certificates, 4 micro-credentials, with a 5th one being added soon. While these are all available to our current students, these credentials also allow those already in their careers to meet continuing education requirements or just to continue to be a lifelong learner. Having these options at Northwestern allows us to serve a diverse student population, no matter how old you are or how far into your career you are. Our goal at Northwestern is to continue to serve our students well, make their experiences the best they can be, and also memorable. Whether they are a first-generation student, a traditional, non-traditional student, or even a student athlete. To accomplish this, we will continue to provide top-notch academic programs that are relevant to the workforce. Our latest data shows that 91% of our graduates who are from Oklahoma are still employed within the state 5 years from graduation. If you add all of our graduates, out of state included, we're still at 85% who are still employed in the state after 5 years. Northwestern provides the workforce for the state of Oklahoma. Our facilities will also play a large role in our students' experience. I also hope you had an opportunity to walk around the campus and see the amazing things that are happening. Renovations continue in our mall area, and hopefully you saw the new Dr. Charles and Jane Tucker Ranger Plaza that we're very excited about. We are also very excited to announce the renovations will begin in Herod Hall this summer, starting with the auditorium. And yes, that means we're getting new seating, flooring, all kinds of things. Yes, let's give a round of applause. Over time, we will also replace flooring and renovate bathrooms and replace windows throughout the building. We could not do this without the commitment of our donors and this community. We've also provided a new resource for our track team with the addition of the Metcalf Family Track, and we just completed turfing our softball field. We want the best for our students, and we will continually to strategically improve our campus facilities. So as you can tell, we've had a great year at Northwestern. Thank you for all your support at our campus, or for our campus community. We are proud of each and every one of you, and we're proud to call ourselves Rangers. And real quick, I want to have one other special introduction. Senator Roland Peterson is here as well. Thank you, Roland, for being here. Now I'd like to ask Paul Kirk, pastor of Alva Wesleyan Church, to come up, who will present our invocation. And please, after the prayer, you may begin with your salad while enjoying a great video highlighting our programs and our students here at Northwestern. Ride Rangers, ride.
Hey, thank you. Thank you so much for the wonderful privilege to be here, for inviting Phoebe and I to get to spend the evening with you guys, and it's a joy to be here. And just for a little fun, I kind of took a look around the room, and we all clean up pretty good, I think. And so it's just a wonderful privilege for Phoebe and I to be here tonight, and so thank you so much for inviting us. Can we just bow our heads for a moment of prayer, please? Father, we say thank you for this beautiful day. Thank you so much for the rain that you have provided for us. We say thank you so much, and we are very grateful. Thank you that we have the wonderful privilege of being in this place tonight to spend time together and to hear wonderful stories, stories of the past and things that are happening in the present. Thank you, Father, for providing all the wonderful people in this room that has made a university like this possible, and it continues to be possible because of generous people. I pray blessings upon them tonight. God, I also pray for the food that we are about to receive tonight. I pray, God, that it would be a blessing to our bodies, and may we eat in fellowship this evening, and may the things that come from our mouths tonight be pleasing to you. We love you, Jesus, and again, thank you for everything that you provided for us, the food and the fellowship tonight. May we use it to furtherance your kingdom and be a blessing in this community. I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Join me as we view the highlights of last academic year. We are proud of the accomplishments of our entire Ranger family, which include our students, faculty, staff, and our communities. Creating tomorrow's workforce is something we strive for daily and continue to see through our programs. Let's celebrate as we journey through the year, highlighting the incredible work of our beloved Northwestern.
Last June, the Northwestern News was honored with the highest award for college newspapers within their respective divisions in the state during the Oklahoma Press Association 2022 Better Newspaper Contest. The Sequoia Award and 25 other honors in various categories were won by the student-produced newspaper.
Sagelyn Booty, a senior agriculture major, has been named a 2023 Campus Compact Newman Civic Fellow. Campus Compact is a Boston-based nonprofit organization working to advance the public purposes of higher education.
This past year marked the start of a new interdisciplinary academic program called the Infant and Early Childhood Mental Health Minor. This program emphasizes the importance of supporting the developing parent-infant relationship and promoting secure attachments. It will provide the ability to prepare students to enter the workforce with key specialized knowledge and elevate the services and resources offered in Northwest Oklahoma.
Blaine Arthur, Oklahoma's Secretary of Agriculture, was on campus during the fall semester to speak to students in our agriculture classes. She gave the students advice on how to master internships and how to achieve their goals for employment. Students were interactive during the question and answer session, and they learned how to communicate the importance of the ag industry to others.
Northwestern Oklahoma State University has been named one of the nation's most affordable online nursing programs by bestcolleges.com. Northwestern's online nursing programs have earned top honors for emphasizing community engagement, affordability, and overall access to higher education.
Homecoming is always a highlight for our year with week-long festivities. The theme this year was Rock Rangers Rock, and our parade marshals were Daryl and Grace Wessels. A record number of student organizations participated in the parade with floats, making this a great celebration for Northwestern.
Our president, Dr. Bo Hannaford, and Redlands Community College president, Jenna Marr, signed a partnership agreement in December to allow Redlands nursing students to seamlessly continue their education in Northwestern. Graduates of Redlands nursing program will be given credit at Northwestern for specific courses already taken.
Megan Spray, a sophomore business management major from Sharon, Oklahoma, was crowned Miss Northwestern 2024, and Christina Jenlick of Alba was crowned Miss Northwestern Teen 2024. Megan performed a drum solo as her talent, and her community service initiative helps the fight against childhood cancer. Megan and Christina will compete in the Miss Oklahoma competition the first week in June. Emily Smith, Miss Northwestern 2023, will also return to the Miss Oklahoma stage this June after recently being crowned Miss Tulsa County. In the June 2023 contest, the Hera Oklahoma senior won the rookie talent honor at her first Miss O competition.
In October, nearly 400 middle and high school students and their advisors were on Northwestern's Alva campus for the Oklahoma Association of Student Councils District 11 Fall Leadership Conference. Northwestern's scholar ambassadors and members of the Alva High School Student Council teamed up to organize this event.
In July, four students in the Bachelor of Science in Nursing to Doctor of Nursing Practice program at Northwestern spent 5 days on the Alva campus for residency week. The students are involved in a hybrid program, meaning that much of their education is completed online. For residency week, the students come to campus for hands-on training.
In September, Northwestern President Dr. Bo Hannaford and Southwestern President Dr. Diana Lovell signed a partnership agreement to allow student passage for continuing education to each university. Two Southwestern School of Nursing graduates have been guaranteed placement into Northwestern's Wisdom Family Foundation doctoral program for rural nursing practice, and two Northwestern chemistry majors will have placements into the Southwestern doctoral program in pharmacy.
The Reichenberger Department of Fine Arts faculty participated in a faculty recital where students, employees, and community members could see the talent of those who teach in this department. This recital was a unique opportunity to showcase the talents and performances that are rarely seen outside the classroom.
In March, Northwestern's Department of Social Work teamed up with Woodward High School for the 10th annual Primp for Prom. This event allows high school students in the Northwest Tri-State area to choose a formal dress and accessories at no charge. Each year, the event gets bigger and better. Those who attend are able to register for a $100 scholarship at Northwestern upon their graduation. Organizers accept donated formal wear and accessories year-round.
The Dr. Charles and Jane Tucker Ranger Plaza is taking shape, and we're excited to see how the campus community will use this space in the future. Sitting between the Science Building and Student Center, where the old boiler room used to stand, is now a leisure space. Concrete has been poured, which created seating, steps, a flat black concrete area, and additional sidewalk areas. This space has the potential for outdoor concerts, outdoor classrooms, studying areas, and more.
Northwestern is continuing its mission to fight against opioid addiction and other stimulant abuse with the installation of a harm reduction vending machine that administers free naloxone and fentanyl test strips. The vending machine is located in the Student Center on the Alva campus and is open to the community. Northwestern hopes these resources will assist in emergencies and offer individuals a chance to recover as opposed to facing fatal repercussions.
Ava Carr, a social sciences major from Tuttle, was selected as a Brad Henry International Scholar by the Oklahoma State Regents for higher education. The Northwestern sophomore has spent the spring 2024 semester studying at Swansea University in Swansea, Wales, United Kingdom.
Rodgers and Hammerstein's musical Cinderella was a fan favorite this year for the Reichenberger Department of Fine Arts. Students could showcase their talents along with faculty, staff, and community members. The actors did a phenomenal job with their parts. The set was amazing, and it was exciting to see the stage production all come together.
Our student athletes amassed almost 500 members of our entire student body. This year brought us a Barton Battisti court dedication inside Percival Fieldhouse, a new track for men's and women's track and field teams named the Vern Metcalf Family Track, and historic seasons for our men's and women's basketball teams. Our softball team is now playing on a new turf at the Alva Recreation Complex, and our men's track team is competing again and setting records after a 27-year absence. All teams take part in community service projects, and we are proud of the effort given this past year by all 15 sports teams. Not only do these individuals excel on a court, field, or in an arena, they're outstanding in the classroom as well.
Ride, Rangers, ride!
Please continue to enjoy eating your dinner as we continue with our rest of our program. Get to my place. I trust that you did enjoy your dinner tonight. I would like to recognize several of the groups that helped bring this spectacular dinner to your table. First of all, our on-site Chartwells, and I am asking them to step out from behind the curtain where all the magic happens. They brought in some help from out of town, and I appreciate you showing your appreciation to them. I also want to recognize our student athletes from the Northwestern soccer team and the Northwestern Scholar Ambassadors. They have served our dinner tonight. They have taken our guests on tours of campus, and they have led our guests to their seats, and they have helped in various ways over the past few days. These individuals are Northwestern's promising alumni of tomorrow. Please show them your appreciation. Austin Rankin has served the past year as the Student Senate President. Austin is a political science major and will graduate this next Saturday. After graduation, he plans to pursue his master's degree in education leadership and administration here at Northwestern. Please join me in welcoming Austin Rankin.
All right, and before you say it, I did not run for this position because I'm a political science major. It was just a coincidence, I promise. Well, like Mr. Allen said, my name is Austin J. Rankin, and I have served in the past year as the SGA 2023 to 2024 president. And it has been the honor of my college experience to hold this position, and it's truly been a fantastic year of service. And today, I'm just wanting to speak with you guys a little bit, kind of talk about what accomplishments we've been able to make with the Student Government Association, and how Northwestern still has and continues to have the most outstanding student body in the state of Oklahoma. Well, absolutely. Well, I came in as a freshman in 2020, the year of COVID-19, and I know a lot of people have their qualms with, you know, 2020, and believe me, so do I. But looking at the silver lining, I guess there are some benefits. I, for one, got to meet my freshman class two times. One, the first semester with the half of their face, and then again, the second semester, once we took the masks off. So I was very lucky in that regard. Outside of that, this year and the Student Government Association has been outstanding. The amount of student body activity here on campus has been monumental. I can remember when I came in as a freshman, at the Student Government Association meetings, there were, you know, consistently 10 to 12 students that would be at those meetings. We now have over 30 students that are continuously at the meetings, representing their different clubs on campus and representing the student body completely. in addition to that, just recently we had our event, Bahama Breakaway. That's kind of like an event right before finals where we have the opportunity for students to come out, have a fun time. When I tell you that we had the most amount of students that I have ever seen at a Bahama Breakaway this past year, just come out, enjoy activities, have different events and possibilities, it has been outstanding. Additionally, this year I had the honor of representing Northwestern Oklahoma State University at the George Nye Leadership Academy in Oklahoma City back in February. After speaking with some of the other student body presidents from the different universities in Oklahoma, I can honestly say that we have the best Student Government Association as well as student body in Oklahoma. And part of that is the work that the Student Government Association has done with the administration, ensuring that students that attend here that are club presidents receive a scholarship. So for those that don't know, the Student Government Association, alongside the administration, offers a $1,000 scholarship per semester to students that are the president of a club. So you can have $2,000 per academic year simply because you're a club president and involved on campus. And from my conversations with other student bodies, that just doesn't happen anywhere else. So that is one outstanding thing about Northwestern. One of the most important lessons that I've learned in the past year is that, you know, first off, there are plenty of students, graduate students, and outstanding individuals that are receiving awards tonight. And those achievements are monumental. They represent thousands, hundreds of hours of work and commitment to the community, campus, and state. But the most important lesson that I've learned, and that each student here at Northwestern learns, is that service to others is the beating heart of our campus, community, and culture here at Northwestern. It's what draws people into the Ranger family, and it's what keeps us here once we've joined. I can say personally that my experiences here at Northwestern have brought me in and made me grow into an outstanding leader that I never would have thought possible during my freshman year. I have been so, so grateful to meet the outstanding individuals that I have while here, to form the connections and relationships that I continue to enjoy today. And I can honestly say that here at Northwestern, you are receiving a valuable education, and that the donations and investments that you are putting into the student body will continue to pay dividends beyond the years that you can see. So thank you each and all of you for being here tonight. Congratulations to those receiving an award. Ride Rangers ride and dogs down.
Thank you, Austin. Tonight, we are blessed to have several former outstanding graduates sharing the evening with us. I will announce their names and ask them to stand, and then I will ask you to hold your applause until they are all named. In the business professional category, we have Jay McDermott and Dr. Peggy Wisdom. In the education category, we have Dr. Jim Seeger Newby and Betsy Zadarozny. In the humanitarian category, we have John Barton. And with us in the Ranger Recognition category, we have Angela Case and Valerie Case. And in the Ranger Spirit category, we have Thelma Crouch. And we have Linda Tutwiler. Please recognize our former outstanding graduates with your applause. Earlier this afternoon, we recognized a number of individuals in an awards ceremony. Dr. Mindy Clark is an associate professor of agriculture, and she has earned the respect and admiration of her students. Dr. Clark was presented with the John Sheffield Teacher of the Year Award, which is selected by the Northwestern student body. Dr. Clark is standing. Please show your appreciation for her work. And it is always fun to introduce students. And next, several students who are set to graduate next Saturday, or who graduated in December of 2023, received various awards which are listed in your program. Some of them have joined us for dinner. Please hold your applause as I ask them to stand and announce their names. Alex Baxter. There he is. Shaylee Beck. Archer Bolin, Jillian Bouse, Jaden Budig, Tabor Booty, Jonas Decker, Kinsey Dixon, Ashley Garner, Abigail Gregory, Draven Hidalgo, Enrique June Koyama Date, Chase McCurley, Shayna Miller, Anna Motika, Juliana Murray, Nai Ramirez, Austin Rankin, and Rebecca Wagner. Please give our graduates a round of applause for their accomplishments. An important part of today was set aside to recognize the alumni who are celebrating 70, 60, 50, 40, 25, 10, and 5 years since their graduation. Dr. Hannaford presented these individuals with their commemorative pins in an earlier ceremony. And our recognition of these honored alumni continues tonight. I will ask each class to stand and please hold your applause until all are standing. With the classmates celebrating 5 years, the class of 2019, please stand. Next, will the classmates celebrating 10 years, the class of 2014, please stand. With the classmates celebrating 25 years, the class of 1999, please stand. And then the classmates celebrating 40 years, the class of 1984, would you please stand? With the classmates celebrating 50 years, the class of 1974, please stand. And finally, with the classmates celebrating 60 years, the class of 1964, please stand. Please celebrate our Honor Cup alumni with your applause. Tonight, Tonight, we are pleased and very proud to honor six individuals whose accomplishments in both their careers and their lives add so much to the heartbeat of Northwestern. They represent the best of the Rangers. On behalf of the Northwestern Oklahoma State University Alumni Board, I am honored and privileged to introduce our 2024 outstanding graduates. Long hours for weeks that turn into months go into a theater production before anyone can consider the traditional film cue of lights, camera, action. Tonight's honoree in the arts category knows well the critical importance of addressing every single detail, large and small, before the curtain goes up. Mickey Jordan's passion for authenticity shows in the costume, set, and scenic design that he oversees. His gift for research brings the audience into both the era and the environment while connecting them with the playwright's characters and the story that is unfolding before them. Mickey was born and raised in Iowa Park, Texas. After working as a professional set designer, prop master, and set dresser in theaters in Texas, he came to Northwestern and earned his undergraduate degree in speech and theater with a minor in visual arts in 2017. While a student at Northwestern, Mickey applied his gifts to several theater productions, and his exceptional talent earned him the Kennedy Center American College Theater Festival Scenography and Dramaturgy Awards in 2017. Mickey continued his academic journey and earned his master's degree in American Studies with an emphasis in theater in 2019. And in the same year, Mickey was hired full-time at Northwestern, bringing his passion for theater in many roles, including the instructor of technical theater and theater history, scenic designer, costume designer, event producer and director, co-choreographer and co-director of musicals and theater productions, theater social media producer, and facilities manager of Herod Hall Auditorium. Since 2019, Mickey has designed 15 theater productions. And tonight, he is still breathing and smiling after putting in months and months of long hours to deliver last week's three stellar performances of Cinderella, all played to a full house. Please join me in welcoming the 2024 Outstanding Graduate in the Arts category, Mickey Jordan.
People often see me running across campus, now you know why. Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor to be recognized as an outstanding alumni. My Ranger experience began when I enrolled as a transfer student to earn a degree in speech theater, a goal that I had previously not thought was possible. I threw myself into everything that Northwestern had to offer and quickly found the community that I needed. A fine arts student through and through, I lived on the third floor of Ryerson Fine Arts and spent many days and nights in Herod Hall Auditorium running events, pageants, and working on productions. I have come to love Northwestern as my alma mater, so much that I completed my bachelor's and graduate's degree and now have the opportunity to share my gifts with students as instructor of technical theater. There is not a person or place on the Alva campus I haven't photographed, borrowed furniture from, or used as a filming location to promote NWOSU theater. When it comes to hunting props and costumings for production, I am thankful for the generosity and the willingness of the faculty and community of Alva. I treasure those connections. The things that draw me to a career in theater, though my parents often wonder why, are opportunities for creative problem solving, the collaboration of artists, and the ephemeral quality of theater. Nothing lasts forever, but the hours labored in creating with others is never misspent, and the end result is always marvelous. In reality, there is this much glamour in a job that is this much hard work, and I love every minute of it, even on the rough days. I use lessons learned at Northwestern daily for her honor and her glory. With the mentoring of Professor Kimberly Waste, I learned how to become a leader in the Herod Hall scene shop and as shop foreman, on stage and now in the classroom. Professor Tammy Brown instilled in me immeasurable lessons in how to effectively collaborate and communicate as a leader. And as always, it depends. Professor Ken Kelsey inspired a wonder and appreciation of art within me, along with the power of making art accessible to everyone. Dr. Sean Holliday has versed me in the practice of celebrating the small things in life with confidence. I thank all of you and the many other mentors and administrators that shaped my Ranger education. And now, as an educator, I would like to formally apologize for everything that I did as a student. I get it now. I know that you knew, and I'm sorry. I'm grateful for the education I have received at Northwestern Oklahoma State University. I am excited for the future of Northwestern, for Herod Hall, and know that it is because of donors and alumni that give back to the university that it will remain a place for people to treasure and return to for years to come. I'd like to thank the Alumni Association, my family, my grandmothers, and the many wonderful community members and friends I have in Alva for this honor. It's a great day to be a Ranger. Thank you.
In the 1980s, then head baseball coach Randy Smith recognized the talent in a young athlete from Tulsa, Oklahoma, and told him, "You need to continue playing baseball." And this year's honoree in the business professional category brought his glove, his passion, and his work ethic to Northwestern. Jeff Allen competed on the Ranger baseball team during the 85, 86, and 87 seasons, earning District 9 first team honors in 1987. Jeff graduated in 1987 with a business administration degree, and during the last semester of his senior year, he began his entrepreneurial career as the owner of Allen Industries. Jeff had one client, American Airlines. His company was responsible for refurbishing seatbelts and other interior items on airplanes. And after 15 years, Jeff closed the business in 2002. But his acumen for successful business was being applied in other areas, starting and acquiring several businesses, some of which he continues to own. While running his businesses, however, the love of the ball diamond called him back as the assistant softball coach at the University of Tulsa from 2010 to 2016, and as the Jinx High School assistant softball coach from 2016 to 2023. Jeff is the owner and CEO of Associated Mortgage Company in Tulsa, which opened in 1992. And under his leadership, AMC has grown to include offices in Oklahoma City, Amarillo, and two locations in Arkansas. According to an employee of AMC, Jeff is the model of a leader who builds loyalty not only with customers, but with his employees through intellect, compassion, and heart. And I quote, "With his enthusiasm and encouragement, we all stand taller, more confident, as individuals and as a team." Beyond the world of business, Jeff is involved in several nonprofit organizations, including Crossover Community School, which provides schooling for grades 8 through 12 underserved students in North Tulsa. He works with Lindsay House in Tulsa, providing housing for women and children with situational homelessness. Jeff is involved with Positive Tomorrows, a school for homeless children in Oklahoma City. And he is passionate about his involvement in the local Tulsa ALS chapter in raising and providing funding for research and families challenged with this disease. Given his schedule, I believe we are fortunate to have Jeff and his wife Joy with us tonight. Please give a Ranger round of applause to the 2024 Outstanding Graduate in the Business Professional category, Jeff Allen.
Wow, that sounded really good. I could have you speak at my funeral. That would be terrific. You know, as I was driving over today, a lot of old thoughts from the 80s, driving to Alva and exit 222 off of the I-35 and onto Highway 11, and Then we hit the storms and some white knuckle deal, and it really took me back and reminded me of a time, not so proud moment, but I got kicked out of a baseball game in Shawnee, playing Oklahoma Baptist, the only time I was ever ejected from a baseball game, and unfortunately. And then my assistant coach got ejected a little bit later. Joe Phillips is here. And we were winning when we got ejected, and then something happened, and OBU came back and ended up winning, and I was shortstop relief pitcher, and I was our closer at the time, and Joe and I are sitting across the parking lot because they threw us out of the completely out of the stadium, and they came back and beat us, and it's not a great ride home. And so that memory on Highway 11 with Coach Smith driving the van was more worrisome than the tornado today. So anyway, thank you for the honor and coming back to Northwestern. What a beautiful campus. Reminiscing, walking around the baseball field and the campus today brought back a lot of memories for me. It served, it was so important to me. It served so many parts of my life that I currently lean on. And I learned leadership here under Coach Smith and Coach Phillips' tutelage. I became a leader here, and I believe that my experiences here have propelled me in my business career. And I was fortunate enough to be able to, as John was saying, start a business my senior year, and it just kind of, I look for opportunities, and when I see them, I take them, and a lot of that has to do with my mentorship from Coach Smith, who I value very much today. So I don't want to take a whole lot, but what a great community and supporting Northwestern and a great cause, the campus, the students, and congratulations. It is awesome, and it holds a very special place in my heart. Thank you, guys.
Honoree in the education category, originally from Wichita, Kansas, came to Northwestern as a transfer student from Cali County Community College, and he joined the Ranger men's basketball varsity team, where he was nicknamed Stretch for the impressive height of his jump. But at 6'5", who wouldn't have an impressive height? Jump. Dr. Kenneth Hamilton graduated with a degree in social sciences in 1968 and went on to earn his master's at Kansas State University and his doctorate at Washington University in St. Louis, Missouri. Dr. Hamilton has gained impressive credentials in his career. He has been published 9 times, including the 2017 biography titled Booker T. Washington in American Memory. His expertise in American minority affairs is sought after. He has participated in or on more than 130 panels, presentations, editorial boards, as a consultant and as an advisor, and several documentaries. In 2021, Dr. Hamilton was honored with the Living Legacy Award from the Association for the Study of African American Life and History. This legacy award honors African American men and women across the nation engaged in extraordinary work to improve communities, institutions, organizations, and family life. Dr. Hamilton continues today to serve as a professor and the director of ethnic studies at Southern Methodist University in Dallas. And according to colleagues and his students, his work in the classroom is legendary. When I first let Dr. Hamilton know of this award, he was humbled, and he said he looked forward to coming back to Northwestern. Unfortunately, he let me know this week that he would be unable to make it to the banquet tonight, but he does extend his deepest appreciation for the honor. I ask that you acknowledge his commitment and his accomplishments with your applause. Dana Jo Stanton came to Northwestern from Buffalo, Oklahoma, looking forward to making new friends and gaining new experiences. While a student at Northwestern, Dana was an active member of the marching band, concert band, jazz band, sound stations, Castle Players, Alpha Psi Omega, and Phi Beta Lambda. Dana's memories of Northwestern includes rehearsals, performances, making those new friends, and having the dedicated faculty who supported her. She graduated in 1993 with her Bachelor of Science degree in Office Administration. She then found her passion for child and family advocacy in her role of grant writer and program coordinator in the Early Connections Policy Program for the Unified School District in Hays, Kansas. She has spent her entire career in the nonprofit education sector. And as I prepared the remarks, I said Dana has secured more than $13 million in grant funding for early childhood programs. But as of yesterday, that mark went up to $30 million. I think we should give her applause for that. She also was instrumental in establishing the Dolly Parton Imagination Library in Ellis County, Kansas. Dana's passion and work for child advocacy goes beyond the Hays, Kansas region, as she is a member of the Kansas Early Childhood Recommendations Panel. A colleague of Dana's said, and I quote, "Dana is driven to achieve the best in programming for children and families. She is relentless and resourceful, both with a smile and a positive spirit. Our children are fortunate to have her work for them." Dana established and continues to manage the Child Care Services Program for the Northwest Kansas Innovation Center in Northern Kansas. And she is here tonight with her husband, Andy. Please join me in welcoming the 2024 Outstanding Graduate in the Humanitarian category, Dana Jo Stanton.
Thank you so much. I was telling the people at my table that the last time that I was in this room was when I graduated college. And back at that particular graduation, we were going to be at the football field, but a thunderstorm came up and we graduated here. Three times during that graduation ceremony, the electricity went out and we all sat in the dark together and waited for us all to cross that stage. So hopefully that will not happen tonight. So it's certainly fair to say that I wasn't probably a particularly stellar student academically during my time at Northwestern, but I was an active student, took part in lots of campus organizations, predominantly those in the fine arts department. Already mentioned organizations like marching band, concert band, jazz band, choir. We called it Soundstations back then. I don't know if they still have Soundstations. I'm university singers and many theatrical productions. Those were not only fun activities for me, but provided the scholarship dollars that funded my education. But just because I didn't always get the best of grades doesn't mean that I didn't benefit from my time in the classroom. Mrs. Mary Louise Turner helped me better hone my writing skills, which have been the basis of my grant writing career. Dr. Gayla DeLong would have never believed that the very poor accounting student she knew would someday be appreciated for her ability to build and track complex grant budgets. My music, theater, and public speaking experiences at Northwestern better prepared me to be at ease in front of large groups. The skill to effectively communicate has been a skill that I rely on again and again, and I will ever be grateful to Mr. John Barton, Dr. Mike Needler, Dr. Rod Murrow, Dr. Ed Huckabee, and of course, Doc Linda Stewart. And while I had scholarships to pay for most of my tuition, college was a struggle for me financially. I always had a job. I worked at Arbic's, remember Arbic's? At Loving's Cafe, I made the curly fries, and I worked at Beeler's Restaurant. And I will never forget two experiences that greatly impacted my life. After finding out that the only meal I had most days was the meal provided at work, Bill and Linda Beeler started leaving groceries in my car at night. I would leave the restaurant. I was the dishwasher. I had a hairnet and a vinyl apron. And I would get to my beat-up car, and I would find a loaf of bread, a gallon of milk, a dozen eggs. And the best was on Friday night, they had a seafood buffet, and they would give us the leftovers from the Friday night seafood buffet. They brushed off my face and told me, don't tell a soul. A few days later, the same time, I received a call from Diana Friend, and I'm sure some of you remember and know Diana Friend. Diana was the mom of my good friend, Michelle Lamont, now Michelle Reed. And Diana said, come to the house. Now, at that time, I never knew if Diana was going to hug me or hit me upside the head for some stupid thing that Michelle and I had done, and we gave her so many opportunities for stupid things. But this time, she hugged me, and she told me that I was a good kid. And she gave me a check for $350. And she told me to go buy some groceries and to pay some bills, and I did, and I got through. These helpful acts at Northwestern, along with many others, have never left me. Over the years, I have cooked meals, filled up gas tanks, and generally mothered every college kid in my life. That tendency is also a part of my professional life. Whether I am being helpful on a one-on-one situation, helping a child care provider fill out a grant application, or on a larger basis, helping advocate statewide solutions for funding of child care, at the most basic level, it is my goal to be helpful, to try to make a difference to others, and to replicate what I learned at Northwestern. And I will forever try to live up to that very Ranger-like standard. In closing, I would like to thank my family. I'm blessed with three beautiful children, Jackson, Gracie, Joe, and Gabe. When they were little, they didn't always understand why I was gone. I hope now that they're all young adults, that they understand and forgive those absences and have learned the value in helping others, especially those less fortunate. I'm joined here tonight by my good friend Matt McAlpin, who I met at Northwestern. And my aunt and uncle Jack and Ruby Stout, also Northwestern graduates, are here with me. I couldn't do what I do every day without a strong support system at home. My sister Tracy, a Northwestern graduate, is part of that support system. Thank you, Tracy. And over, let's see, next 2 weeks from now, my husband Andy and I will celebrate our 25th wedding anniversary. Over those 25 years, I have been loved, a little nagged, encouraged, challenged, supported by him. And I thank you for all of that. I love you. Finally, I'd like to thank my mother, Carol Jo Goki, who passed away 14 years ago. Although she wanted to, she was never able to attend college. My sister and I had no choice but to attend college. It was a non-negotiable for her. I wish she was here tonight. I know she would be proud of me, and I know that she would be grateful to you, as I am, for this wonderful honor.
The acting bug bit our next honoree when she began her acting career at the age of 6 with the Woodward Arts Theater and Missoula Children's Theater. In high school, Sarah Costa, our honoree in the Ranger Recognition category, questioned whether she could pursue a career in acting. Enter, stage left, Northwestern Oklahoma State University and its theater program. Sarah immediately became immersed in the opportunities to learn every aspect of theater taught at Northwestern. And here she learned to endure the long hours that would serve her well in the future. She graduated in 2014 with a degree in speech and theater. After graduation, she briefly taught speech and reading in the Woodward Public Schools. But stage work and acting called her, and she moved to Florida, where the entertainment industry was strong with many opportunities. While in Florida, Sarah worked in various roles in the entertainment and theme park arenas. When the pandemic impacted that industry, Sarah moved back to Woodward and began auditioning for roles virtually. Eventually, she was selected as a backup performer for 1883, the fictional prequel to Yellowstone, the popular series on the Paramount Network. And no one said the role and the work involved would be glamorous. Sarah portrayed a gypsy immigrant who was giving her family a new start with a journey across America in a covered wagon. She endured 14-hour days with temperatures reaching to 113 degrees in Texas, but she got a cool respite when she went to Montana and they had 11-degree days. The experience was demanding, and Sarah is grateful for the work ethic created by the Northwestern Theater Program. Until her next acting role, Sarah is staying busy serving as a multimedia rep for the Woodward News. Please welcome the 2024 Outstanding Graduate in the Ranger Recognition category, Sarah Acosta.
When I graduated high school, I had dreams of the big city lights, bustling downtowns, and that didn't work out for one reason or another. So I came here to Northwestern, and I had given away my acting dream altogether until a friend pulled me into Kimberly Weiss's office and says, you need to see her. She needs to be in acting. And so there began my long hours here, staying busy in Herod Hall and learning everything from backstage work, scenery, props, costuming, anything that I didn't really even understand that was involved in acting before I got to college. And so I graduated with a myriad of understandings in the theatrical world, and I wanted to pursue that in my adult life. And so, as I found out that, as I used to think, I'll just wait until I get my job doing specifically theater or specifically art, that I'll just have enough time to do that. Well, no, that's not how that works. Real life gets in the way. You have to get jobs that pay the bills and things that keep your life afloat. So art has to happen wherever you are. So when I came back here and I began my film journey, I was ever so grateful for everything that Weiss had taught me, from humility to being a part of a group and being in something bigger than yourself. So in conclusion, I would like to thank Kimberly Weiss for believing in me. And I would also like to thank my parents and the people that I have in my life that support me, because without them, I would never be able to do what I am doing today, and I am still able to dream. So thank you.
The Outstanding Graduate in the Ranger Spirit category has been described as all in when it comes to Northwestern Oklahoma State University. Myra Davison, originally from O'Keene, Oklahoma, graduated from Northwestern in 1986 with a Business Administration Office Administration degree. And from 1984 until her retirement in 2022, Myra has served Northwestern in several roles, finishing as the assistant to the president for former president, Dr. Janet Cunningham. Grace, dignity, optimism, and the undeniable love for everything Ranger have been characteristics of Myra the entire time. Myra has many great accomplishments and memories, including the distinction of receiving the Thelma Crouch Employee of the Year Award in 2020, earning the title of overall female award winner in the homecoming 5K Ranger Run, not just once, but in 1987, 1988, 1991, and 1993. And she fondly remembers singing for President Janet Cunningham's investiture in 2007. She continues to be a beloved presence at Northwestern athletic and social events, as well as its theater and fine arts productions. When we announced our roster of 2024 outstanding graduates earlier this year, several of Myra's large fan base expressed that she was the perfect person to be selected for the Ranger Spirit category. So I took advantage of these conversations and I gained some insight and opinions into our Myra, including Myra lights up every room she enters. Myra's energy begins with her smile and then it just blossoms. Myra is optimism overload. She knows that it will always be a silver lining. Myra is everything Ranger, and there is no better cheerleader for Northwestern than Myra. Myra is here tonight with her husband, Ron. Please give a warm and spirited welcome to the 2024 Outstanding Graduate in the Ranger Spirit category, Myra Davison.
I don't think that I'm gonna cry, I may faint. Oh, thank you so much, John. Thank you, Skeeter Bird, and thank you, President Hannaford. This evening is all so very nice. It is a wonderful thing to receive this honor, this recognition, just because I love my university. I'll tell you, the last few weeks have been a whirlwind of activity and preparation here in Alva for this evening. There was a manicure, a pedicure, a facial, I got my hair cut, and I had my teeth cleaned. I think I'm good to go. Several months ago when John called me to tell me that I was being honored with the Ranger Spirit Award, I was away from the house running some errands, and I said, well, wow, that is wonderful. So later in the afternoon I got home and I was telling my husband Ron that I found out that I'm going to be receiving this award, and he says, huh. He said, are you sure that he meant to call you? Let me introduce my husband, Ron Davison. He is a 1976 graduate of Northwestern and a current member of the Rowdy Rangers. And Ron has some Ranger spirit. He enjoys talking to the referees, to the umpires, to the officials at any and all Ranger games. He usually says a little too much. I try not to sit by him. My other guests here tonight are my sister, Emily Bolin, and her husband, Dr. David Bolin. Neither of them received their degrees from Northwestern, but they are Rangers through and through. They have Ranger spirit. Both are former employees of Northwestern, and for 35 years, they have cooked meals every Wednesday night at the First Christian Church during the school year for any student who wants to go and eat. They sometimes cook for 10 students, sometimes for 110 students. Twice in recent years, Emily and Dr. B have been named Fans of the Year as voted in by our college athletes at the annual Northwestby Awards. My other guests this evening are Dr. Janet Cunningham. She is here this evening. Her husband, Rick, could not be here. I knew he would figure out some way to get out of this. But Dr. Cunningham and Rick are the Ranger dynamic duo, for sure. Dr. C is, of course, our former university president, and I first got to know her in 1979 when I came to college. She was one of my instructors. I was fortunate that Dr. C always had confidence in me, and we worked together here many years. Now, this is funny, because during those years, her husband, Rick, attended just about as many Northwestern events as she did, but unfortunately, he could not be here this evening. As they attended all these events and had their busy lives, they also raised four children, and Rick had his law practice. And so it might have been Ranger spirit, or it could have been Ranger magic, that kept their busy lives in order. The Cunninghams made it look easy. And Rick, I want to say that Rick was always very supportive of me as well, and always was very appreciative of any help that I could give Dr. Cunningham. I want to say thank you to all of my special guests for coming and being here with me tonight. Ranger spirit is everywhere. All of you have Ranger spirit. You can see it certainly in financial support, but it's there in your kind words, in your attendance, when you offer encouragement, when you say, I can help, or when you say, I'll cook some food, or when you say, it is nice to meet you, welcome to Northwestern. You are gonna love it here. There are three ladies who have previously been given the Ranger Spirit Award. Thelma Crouch, Phyllis Brunstetter, and Linda Tutwiler. I worked at Northwestern with all of them, and they are my friends. I really feel that our campus would not be as it is today if those three ladies were not a part of its history. Aunt Phyllis is gone now, but to Thelma and Linda, thank you. You ladies know how to be Rangers. Northwestern has done so much for me, really everything. I learned a few things while I was here. I made friends here. I worked here for forever. Northwestern gave me the life that I have. Congratulations to everyone who was honored today. Any day is a great day to be a Ranger. Thank you so much. Ride, Rangers, ride.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give our 2024 outstanding graduates another round of loud and loving. Quickly, I would like to, there are a couple of other groups that I would like to recognize tonight. The Northwestern Alumni Board has had its hand in this event, as they do with much of our programming. The Outstanding Graduate Committee pours over the nominations and makes their selections to put in front of the Alumni Board for approval. The Outstanding Seniors Committee reviews the Outstanding Senior Packets and make those selections. Every board member is an integral part of the success of the Alumni Association, and I am indebted to them. Several of our members are here tonight, and I would like to ask them to stand. Sherry Ward, who you have met, Megan Rice, Mickey Stout, Ethan Sackett, and Austin Rankin. Please show them your appreciation. This day of celebration would not have been possible without the great work and wonderful talent of the Ranger family, who I have the privilege of working with every weekday and even some Saturdays. Friends, as I call your name, please stand, remain standing, and we will show you our appreciation once I have read your names. First is Kennedy Dietz, Marketing and Communication Manager. Stephanie Lambert, Office Manager. Michelle Shelight is our Relationship Manager. Jeremy Judd is our Database and Research Manager. And Tony Lustenau is our Financial Manager. Please show this group of dedicated individuals your appreciation. Skeeter's looking at me like, what's he going to say now? I now have the honor of introducing the man who we call our leader and our mentor. Skeeter Bird, the Chief Executive Officer of the Northwestern Foundation and Alumni Association, is a 1985 graduate, and he has led this organization since 2005. Please join me in welcoming Skeeter Bird.
So you may have seen me checking my pants. I spoke at my daughter number three's wedding, and I just got started, and my wife started waving me, kind of interrupting me, and I had one pant leg way up here. Fortunately, am I okay? I look okay, sweetheart? Before, it was very distracting. And you know, I've had three daughters get married, and the thing about those events, you only get one shot to do that right. And so there's a lot of pressure, and but I made it through after I got my pant leg where it needed to be. I'm going to talk about some students, and I will tell you in advance things that get me emotional is talking about my daughters and talking about students. So bear with me, but I'm going to make a run at this. But first, I'm going to talk about potential achievement and investment. And I hope to frame these concepts a little differently based on a book I recently read. The book is called Hidden Potential, The Science of Achieving Greater Things by Dr. Adam Grant. In this book, the author offers a different manner of measuring achievement. Many of us look at the apex of a career to measure professional success when we define achievement. Rarely do we consider the overall distance traveled as that success. When a person standing metaphorically on Denali in Alaska at over 20,000 feet, we don't usually know that they started down in Death Valley at a minus 272. Dr. Grant suggests that to really measure achievement and success, we should consider where a person starts and distance traveled instead of just where the pinnacle that they reach. He shares the story of Jose Hernandez, who began his career as a migrant worker but later worked his way to becoming an astronaut, as a perfect example of hidden potential and high achievement. With one third of our students being the first generation college students, I found this book relevant to what happens here at Northwestern. So many of our students grow up without a vision of how higher education can change their life. So many of our students cannot even imagine attending college or becoming a doctor, a lawyer, a nurse, a teacher, or other professional of their dreams. I have met many of these students, heard their stories, and countless times wondered how they made it to college. These are the types of people who I love to see our donors invest in. I've always loved the underdog story, always. Of the Bible, David and Goliath is my favorite story. We have several underdog stories in this room tonight, but I'm going to focus on just a few. One underdog story I want to share with you, or hidden potential story, is with us this evening. One of our first generation students was selected as an outstanding senior. I'd like to introduce again Nahi Ramirez. Nahi, would you please stand up? Please give a round of applause. We Alumni is a first-generation college student, a first-generation American, and she went to school as an English language learner. In her own words, and I quote, "I grew up in a single-parent, low-income household from a culture where school is not prioritized, but is discouraged. Nye plans to be an elementary education teacher." How many of you want to bet she's going to be phenomenal? I would. I want to share with you another hidden potential story. This family story actually starts much earlier, but because of limited time, we're going to start on January 4th, 1985. On that day, a 35-year-old woman went to a doctor in Winoka to have her pain in her leg examined. During what should have been a routine examination, a blood clot broke loose in her leg, traveled to her lungs, and caused her to die on the examination table. On the date of her death, she had five daughters, ages 19, 17, 14, 6, and 3. The 19-year-old was in her second year of college. The 17-year-old was recently married and trying to finish high school. The other three were still at home. There was no life insurance. The mother had just started a new job, had signed up for life insurance, but had not spent enough time to make the minimum time for the insurance policy to be in effect. The father was a gifted plumber and electrician, but was shackled by a couple of addictions that held him back. He never was able to reach his full potential professionally or financially, unexpectedly losing his wife drove him further into his addictions. Based on our life experiences, who in this room would have bet on a positive outcome from this situation? Who among us would have seen the potential in these young ladies and bet they would have achieved any level of success? Yet in spite of many challenges, all five daughters completed their college degrees, thanks a lot to a lot of hard work, the state of Oklahoma, and many scholarship donors. I want to give you an education recap. Daughter number one, after 2 years at Northwestern, later transferred and completed a degree in business at Kansas State University, 8 years after she started. Daughter number two, married while still a junior in high school, managed to finish her senior year of high school. She then spent 9 years attending Northwestern before she graduated with a degree in accounting. Daughter number three completed a degree in education in 5 years at Northwestern. Daughter number four completed a degree in speech and theater education in 5 years at Northwestern. And finally, daughter number five completed her degree in Spanish in 4 years at Northwestern. Three of them are teachers, one is an accountant, one is an entrepreneur with her husband. Now this may seem like a great place to end the story, and I'll tell you every day these women are making a difference for our students, our local students, and our local economy. But the best part of this story is what happened to the next generation. The next generation did not start in Death Valley. The next generation started with a vision of possibilities. And I believe what happened for the children of these five women, these women who were the first in their family to receive a college education, is what can and does happen for the children of our students today. The students are the first generation to attend college for their family. In the story of this family, I can tell you what happens 39 years later. If Ray and Jenny Nutter were still alive, they would have 15 grandchildren. 11 of these 15 grandchildren are of college age or older. 10 of these 11 have a college degree or are in the process of attaining a degree. In fact, one of the grandchildren is an outstanding senior this year. All but one of these degrees was completed here at Northwestern. As you know, every family has one of these, what I would call a gray sheep sometimes. The ones that go to Southwestern. Yes. Well, this young lady went to Southwestern, she got her pharmacy degree, and she's a pharmacist here at Holder Drug in Alva. So she's back in that family fold, everything's good. Most of the third generation is employed here in Woods County. I want to run down the list of professionals working in our community. There are two farmers, one information technology specialist, one barber, one pharmacist, one veterinarian, one dentist. Employed outside Woods County is one nurse and one entrepreneur. Three of these five sisters are here this evening. None of them knew what I was going to talk about. I'd like to introduce them. First one, sister number one, Raylan Bird, please stand. Sister number three, Gina Bolin, would you please stand? And sister number four, Jody Brott, is in the back. Would you ladies please stand? Please give them a round of applause. I'm probably going to owe them some mascara afterwards. We also have a couple of grandchildren with us tonight. Archer Bolin's an outstanding senior. His sister, Hadley Bolin, is a sophomore here at Northwestern. Would you two please stand? If you get a chance to talk to them later this evening, please ask them more about their story, and please ask them not to kill me afterwards. I told you I wanted to talk to you about potential, achievement, and investment. How many of us would have seen the potential and expected the achievement from these five women? How many of us would have predicted the achievement from their children? How many of us would have invested in those five girls with your charitable gifts in 1985? Some people did. I want you to leave here tonight knowing that when you invest in a student, there is no question in your mind that you're going to make a huge difference for them. But I also want you to know there's a really good chance you're going to make an impact in so many generations after them. Thank you for listening. Next, we have the pleasure of Dr. Karsten Longhurst. Yeah, you guys are on. While they're getting ready, I will share with you, some of you don't know this, a lot of you do. I spent 21 years in the military, and I have listened to the national anthem I don't know how many times, but when they sing it, it always hits me right here. They are phenomenal. Please welcome the University Singers, Dr. Karsten Longhurst.
Yeah. ocean or the rain from above. You can try to stop the paradise we're dreaming of, but you cannot stop the rhythm of two hearts in love to stay.
Cause the battle land in my hand. to invite you to stand and sing the alma mater with us, followed by Ride Rangers Ride the Fight Song. The words for those pieces are in the back of your program, so please feel free.
Celebration, wouldn't you agree? Thank you again, University Center. Wonderful. Friends, we'd like to ask if you would please feel free to leave your name badges on the table so that we might use them again in future events. Also, any guests who would like to take home some of the flowers on your centerpieces on your table, you're welcome to do so. We will, however, need to keep the vases, so there will be students and staff at the top of the stairs who will help transfer the tulips to floral bags if you'd like to take those home with you. This has been a wonderful day and a great evening. We hope you have enjoyed it as much as we have. Safe travels, God bless, and good night.